smile.
Hi, and welcome to This Is Your Life. Well, as you can see, the studio is set, and we're all ready to honour a performer who has literally been idolised around the nation. Plenty of well-known faces are rolling up to celebrate the life of a country kid who has defied his critics and battled the odds to become the most successful chart topper in Australian music history. And as usual, our guest of honour was in the dark about tonight's celebration until we surprised him earlier today. Our guest of honour will shortly walk up this laneway to what he thinks will be an interview. But we've lured him here so fake paparazzi can pounce on him over some fictitious scandal about to erupt in his life. So, let's see how he reacts.
Shannon,
can I ask you two questions?
Tell us about this latest scandal. Surely everyone's owed an explanation. Why did you let yourself be involved in this outrageous scandal? What would you like to say to people who bought your album?
Ask the question, Shannon.
What's going to happen to the
community?
Do you feel sorry for your fans, Shannon?
Surely everyone's owed an explanation. Surely they are. Come on, tell us. What would you like to say to everyone who's bought your albums? What would you like to say to the fans?
What's happened?
How did you get yourself involved in this scandal?
I don't know what the scandal is.
Shannon Noll.
Get it all
What were you thinking?
Crikey, how going? What's happened? I'm trying to think. Did you run over someone in the car yesterday? What's happened?
Shannon, do you think you might have played up?
I'm trying to think. Where was I? What's going on there?
Give me a shake.
Oh, mate, that's a ripper. That's a ripper.
As we celebrate the talent and accomplishments of Shannon Noll.
Shannon Noll.
My first impression of Shannon was that he was just a rock and roll steed, a handsome lad with an amazing voice.
He likes to work. He likes to work hard. He wants to be better. He wants to make better records.
What makes Shannon so successful is Australia has embraced him.
With Shannon, it's total charisma. And also, he's a great entertainer.
One of the hottest debated things about Shannon Noll is yay or nay for the Flavour Saver.
Hey, how you going? I'm Shannon Noll, and that's what I'm talking about.
It's the Errol Flynn tickler.
What's a Flavour Saver?
Ladies and gentlemen, Shannon Noll. Take a seat, mate.
Oh, wow. Thanks for that.
You don't really mean that, do you? It wasn't until you took your sunglasses off that I realised that you were seriously worried.
Well, you know, a lot of times there's probably something to worry about.
And it did cross your mind that you'd done something that you couldn't have remembered.
Well, you saw, yeah, it was a bit panicking for a minute because I'm trying to think I haven't done anything bad.
What
lately.
Have I done? You have been in trouble, you know.
Yeah,
2004,
yeah,
there was a DUI, and in March this year, you apologised to fans.
Yep.
It seems everything you do these days is in the spotlight. And our next guest is someone who knows exactly how that feels. He's also a very, very good mate of yours. Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Guy Sebastian. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. Please take a seat.
How's that? When did you find out?
Just walking down that street.
Isn't that great?
Now, you guys, your careers, both your careers have just absolutely taken off since Idol. And, Guy, you've remained good friends, haven't you?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we obviously don't see each other as much as we did in the Idol house. but it was amazing. I mean, we went through a pretty amazing thing together, you know. Definitely. It was sort of... I remember even times, like in the hotel room, we'd all be stressing out about the song and trying to arrange the song. And I remember hearing Shannon sing the first time, and he would sing R&B, you know, and he'd do all the licks, all the runs and everything, and then he'd sing a rock song and nail that too, and just so versatile. And I remember he'd be going, "You're going to win this, mate." And I'd be going,
"First time I met him, you're going to win this, man."
And I'd be saying, "No."
Come second behind you.
And I'd be saying, "No way, you're going to win, for sure."
Shannon, tonight is obviously about celebrating with family and friends.
Yep.
And there are two family members who couldn't make it here tonight, relatives of yours,
yep.
but they did manage to send this message.
G'day, Cuz. Congratulations, mate. Actually, I still find it hard to believe we're related after hearing about your cricket exploits and my ability behind the microphone, but things have certainly changed over a period of time. I remember 10 years ago, a young country kid wanting a couple of tickets to the cricket. These days, when I go to my kids' school, all they want to know is whether I'm related to the famous Shannon Knowles, and I'm really proud of what you've achieved, so have a fantastic night.
G'day, Shannon. Sorry I can't be there tonight, mate, but congratulations on what you've achieved so far in your career. Shannon, you cost me a fortune during Idol. Every time you were singing, I had to text and phone in. You were so good, I just had to keep voting for you, mate. So any day now, you can send me a cheque and pay back that phone bill. Have a great night, mate. Enjoy yourself.
We did try and also get the War Boys to explain exactly how you're all related.
Yep.
Have a look.
My mother's mother's brother's grandson.
I believe my grandmother's brother is your grandfather, and that's how we're related.
No, the relation...
I mean, that's what I've been told, so I believe.
So my grandmother's brother's grandson, that's what Shannon is.
How's this saying, guys? You give me that quizzical look there, like, what's wrong?
We're actually triplets. Don't we look like triplets?
My grandmother's brother is your grandfather. I think that's it.
I don't know.
I'm not sure how it works.
Doesn't really matter. Apparently we're cousins anyway.
Yeah, can you simplify it in one sentence for us?
Yeah, my grandfather's sister's their grandmother.
Okay. All righty, stay with us because after the break, Shannon comes face to face with a long-time rival who needs to clear the air.
Congratulations, Knowlesy, on your big night. One of many big nights. In fact, every night is a big night for Shannon Noll, but this one is particularly big. We remember the first moment that you walked into the audition room. The judges knew we had a star on our hands.
Why don't you just sort of give us a song then?
Okay.
Hold me in your arms. Look, Shannon, you were special to us the day that we first met you. And you remain to be so, and we're very, very proud of you.
And we have just discovered her voice.
Yes.
You have a very special place in my heart.
It just sealed the deal. You are a bloody star. You're an Australian icon in the making. God bless you, Knowlesy. Love you.
Welcome back to This Is Your Life and Shannon Noll. Shannon, we just saw your audition for the very first series of Australian Idol back in 2003. And one person who spotted your talent very early on was Dicko Dixon. He joins us now, along with the musical director of the show, John Foreman. John, take your seat.
All right.
Now, at times, Dicko, you were a very cruel and very cold judge.
That was karaoke. I hope you don't go down the route of too much Australiana. You've got to start going forward. I'm serious. You moved as though you're moving up a bloody deli queue. Next week, we're down to six people. You need to learn to move a bit better. You've got to move forward, Shannon. That was backwards.
You gave him a hard time, didn't you?
Shannon, I'd like to say now I unreservedly apologise for the hair, not the comment. The thing is, as you saw, I used to give Shannon quite a hard time because, you know, I just felt he needed pushing, just so he could believe himself, really. But I think I went a little bit far one night, and my wife would tell you this, I couldn't sleep, I was rolling around in the bed all night, and in the end, I couldn't stand it. I snuck downstairs to the kitchen, got my phone, and voted for him 10 times. Naked. My wife comes down, she said, what are you doing? I went, nothing. She went, show me the phone. I went, no. She went, show me the phone, we're having an affair. I went, it's Shannon.
I'm sure this is news to Guy. Did you know one of the judges was in the kitchen stark naked not voting for you?
What sort of a tart do you think I am? I'll vote for two blokes.
And in fact, you guys, since Idol, as you mentioned, have become close and have had a little something done together.
Yes.
Oh, I don't know what he was talking about then. They knew. They're on to us.
I just got through my permanent residency and I was just amazed and I felt, I've got to mark this down. I said, Shannon, I'm going to go and have the Southern Cross tattooed on my arm. And he went, mate, I'm there. Let's be sons of Australia together.
Yeah. Are you able to show us now?
Is it sure.
A bit, there we go. And, John, what do you think has always stood out about Shannon?
Oh, that is fantastic, by the way. I think Guy and I, we should go out afterwards and get the saucepan or something like that. I remember, seeing that footage of Shannon's very first audition there when he came in and sang Hold Me In Your Arms and then went on to sing songs like Better Man and so on, the beautiful, quiet ballads. And then there was a point at the series where he became really confident in his own skin and decided to really dig deep and make his own decisions. To see the development through the show was fantastic.
Okay. That first Idol contest back in 2003 is both close and full of controversy, particularly when fellow finalist Cosimar De Vito unexpectedly drops out of the competition.
Unfortunately, I have a temporary condition that's affecting my voice. It's forced me to make the decision to leave the competition.
Now, Shannon, Cosimar's departure clears the way for you to make the grand final and go up against Guy. There's no way that Cosimar was going to miss tonight's show. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Cosimar De Vito. Now, you must look at these two guys, Guy and Shannon, and think what might have been had you not had to drop out.
Look, you know what? I'm happy it was them two. You know what? Regardless of what would have happened, he deserved to be in the top two, and his success is a testament to that.
Thanks, Dan.
You know what I mean? Like,
did you?
That's it. So, and I was a big fan from the beginning, right from the beginning, like that big, powerful, passionate voice. It was just, he had me from the beginning.
Okay. All right, well, thanks, Cosimar. Thanks for joining us. With Cosimar no longer in the competition, it's down to the wire between you two as over 3 million Australian viewers tune in to see whether Guy Sebastian or Shannon Noll will become the first ever Idol winner.
The winner of Australian Idol 2003 is... Guy Sebastian.
Guy, that is a life-changing moment, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. You know, our lives have totally been changed from that. It's been a real big trip, and I'm so proud of Shannon and so proud of what he's done, not only musically, but also the person he's been.
Yeah, but of course it's your ability to reach and relate the average Australian that has maintained your success since Idol. And not everyone, I have to say, has been happy to see you make it.
Here we go.
He calls himself an Australian Idol. Pig's ass!
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Reg Reagan.
Hey, mate. Hey, mate.
year.
Yeah, righto, Reg, what is your problem, mate? What is your problem?
You look great, mate. How are you? You're doing really well. Still doing the yoga?
Still doing the yoga. Yeah, still keeping trim, taut and terrific?
No, you look great. Hey, Cosmo, how are you, darling?
Good, how are you?
Hello, how are you? Thanks very much.
Hey, old son, how are you? Come on, who are you? Oh, I tell you what. Mike, I can tell you some stories about this bloke.
I've known him since he was a tacker. Back when I was the publican at the condo hotel. I remember this young bloke, only 18 years of age, him and his mates used to come in every Friday night, chase a bit of skirt, Mike. Right, we all used to do a bit of that in our time, even the old ones. And he was out there, really off the rails, and but he could sing. Even back then, he could sing like a bird. Particularly if you give him a grab on the wheels, eh? But no, I hate watching talent go to the wayside. And I remember one night at the pub, and you know, I pulled him aside, Dicko, and next to the jukebox, just left of the dartboard, and I pulled him in tight and just tell him what I told you.
Yeah, no, I remember that. Yeah, that was a moment between us, mate. A moment I'll never forget.
No. Me neither. Ah, oh, good clean man, better than a dirty woman anyway. So, why are we here again?
Okay. Well, you weren't happy. You're not happy. You said there was a problem. You had a problem with Idol.
Yeah, I was, you know, I'm not here to piss in his pocket like the rest of you suckholes. I'm here to tell him like it is. And yeah, I was there and like the rest of the contestants, I got taken to the room, you know, with Dick and Holden. And I just didn't cut it. I mean, I'm a desperate. There's even some things I won't do.
No.
Yeah. But, no, it's great to be here tonight, Mike. I really appreciate it. And son, there's something you forgot. Hey? The old flavour saver. I can tell you as an 18-year-old, how many flavours? Fantastic. There
we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Reg Magan. Takes a while to recover, doesn't it, really?
Yeah, I reckon that one's a classic.
Shannon, even as that runner-up, you are swept away by the whole Idol phenomena, but always have remained true to yourself. Have a look.
Hey, Shannon.
How you going?
I'm so sorry I couldn't be there tonight, but congratulations on all of your achievements over the last few years. Nobody deserves it more than you.
Mate, congratulations on everything. It's seriously, it's well deserved. You are an absolute legend. I remember the first time that we met was at Sydney at the Idol auditions, the top 100, and I got you to sing Hold Me In Your Arms for my brother down the phone. I thought, this guy's going places.
You're probably one of the hardest workers in this country, and that is probably the reason you've become such an icon for Australia. You're so friendly and outgoing and just such a larrikin.
Amazing voice, amazing bloke. Congratulations, mate.
Welcome back to This Is Your Life and Shannon Noll. Well, Shannon Neil Noll, you're born on the 16th of September, 1975. There he is, the youngest of three boys. You grow up on the family farm near Condobolin in western New South Wales. And Shannon, yours is a loving and very close-knit family. All you've got to do is ask your beautiful mum, Sharon. How are you?
How are you?
Take a seat, man.
Thank you.
But Sharon, you've always called Shannon your little gift. Why?
Well, probably not a lot of people know that Shannon was born prematurely, a month premature, and he was only 4.5 pounds at birth. Then all through his life, he was just a lovely, delightful child. So his dad and I always considered him to be a gift.
And lucky still to have him with you after all he's been through, his injuries.
Talk about it.
Nine lives. Yes,
for sure.
You can imagine, Mike, three boys on 4,500-acre property. They had their motorbikes, they had their slug guns, they had everything. Well, it was a thrill a minute rearing them. I think he was going to do that video and send it into...
Funny Son Video.
Yes.
Funny Son Video. Well, those two brothers of yours are still very glad that you're still here in one piece, Shannon.
Me too.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Damien and Adam Noll. Good to see you, mate. Now, Damien, you, the three of you have been playing in different bands, I think, since your early teens, haven't you?
Yeah, that's right, Mike. Music's been a huge part of our life. We sort of played in a lot of different groups and things, but always together. And probably the most noted one was Cyprus, that we all played in together. And, yeah, we used to rehearse at a shearing shed at home, and we actually owned two blocks, and they were 10 kilometres apart. And the neighbours used to know when we'd finished work because... We'd get up there and the music would start, mate, and the shed was like a huge loudspeaker. It just jettisoned it 10 kilometres away so they could hear it.
10Ks?
10Ks, mate, yeah.
Lucky neighbours.
Yeah.
Oh, they were loud, Mike. Oh.
But then in 2001, a sudden and freakish accident kills your dad, Neil, on the farm. 1 minute he's there, and the next, the family is in complete turmoil. Because, Shannon, your dad was always the linchpin for all of you, wasn't he, really?
Yeah, well, he was the man of the house, you know. So, we really looked up to Dad. He didn't do too much wrong, so...
No.
We sort of thought of him as a bit of a hero of ours, you know.
And, Damien, you were with your dad when the accident happened. Shannon wasn't too far away.
Yeah, that's right, Mike. We were moving an overhead fuel tank and it disturbed one of the legs on the other tank that was standing beside us that had 2,000 litres of fuel in it. And, of course, I was on one side of the thing and Dad was on the other and it just collapsed and fell on top of him and that was it. It was sort of... Shannon was just coming through the gate and thought we were mucking around.
Yeah, I thought, what are these rat bags?
Yeah, and it sort of... Yeah, it was probably the lowest point in our lives, I think, just to know that, you know, I mean, we tried as hard as we possibly could, you know, tried to resuscitate him.
You saved him once on the way to hospital.
Yeah, we got a breath out of Dad on the way to the hospital, but I don't know.
Might.
Yeah, he might know. Yeah.
And of course, Adam, it was your dad who always encouraged music in the family.
Mate, yeah, Dad was a great guy. We obviously had a good family base, so we travelled a lot in the car. We live at condo, so you got to travel hours and hours to get anywhere. And We had a great country music base in Australia. He was a big fan of John Williamson. JW was his galleries of pink guitar, Glass and Trouble and things. The songs, I think, will live with us forever and ever, and it was a special part of growing up.
Well, tonight we thought that we would honour the special relationship that you all had with Neil Noll.
Hey, Trouble, don't say you've gone. Say you've knocked off for a smoker and you'll be back later on. Hey, true blue. True blue. True blue. Face to face. Are you really disappearing? Just another dying race. Hey, true blue. True blue. Is it me and you? Is it mom and dad? Is it a cockatoo? Is it standing by your mate when he's in a fight? or will she be right? True blue, I'm asking you. Is it me and you? Is it mom and dad? Is it a cockatoo? Did it stand by your mate when he's in a pipe? Or will she be right?
And stay with us, because after the break, Shannon sings his way into the Australian music history books. You must have really made it big if comedians are impersonating.
Yeah, funny story about that, actually. I was doing the Arias one year, and Rove, I think, was hosting, and they played that film clip. And it just got to the part, because my little fellas, Cody and Blake, knew I was performing that night on the show. So, because at the end of it, someone on the lawnmower runs over me, and there's just my boots sitting there with these bloody stumps hanging out at the end of my head. And they're sitting there, they go, what happened to Dad? What happened to Dad? And,
well, your version of the Moving Pictures ballad is a roaring success. The song not only tops the Australian charts in 2004, but also those in Ireland. It's a big year, and it gets much, much bigger when you marry your longtime sweetheart, Rochelle Ogston. Now, for you, it was love at first sight for this bloke, wasn't it?
It was, yeah.
you say that in a very determined way, but just tell us how determined you were.
Shannon moved to Sydney to play football, and he happened to be playing the same team as my brother. And my sister's 18th was coming up, so my brother took Shannon along just for some male company, because there was going to be so many females there. And
I don't know what I would want to go for.
Shannon and Damien were out in the front of the boat playing guitars and singing along, and I remember my sister come down to me and say, what do you think about Shannon? I said, too late, I like him.
And of course you two then become inseparable, so much so that you actually sneak into the Idol house while Shannon is in there, right?
It was like a jail. He snuck here, you know, and then go for your life. Quick, we'll shut the door. Okay, time's up, you've got to go.
You were sleeping there.
Yeah, there's security guards at sort of the top of the driveway, the bottom of the house, and they let me in.
I was the only culprit. Millsy snuck a couple in the back.
Millsy?
And your son.
Oh, mate, Millsy would have 14 then.
There was a path for him to have that little back door that he had.
Well, despite Idol now well and truly behind you, your talent and popularity are obvious. Your debut album goes 5 times platinum and stays in the charts for almost a year. Then you commit to a grueling national tour so you can go right around the country thanking all those Aussies who voted for you. And two people in the business are here to vote for you tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Troy Cassadaly and Richard Clapton. So if I could start with you, what is Shannon's appeal to the average Australian? What is it about him?
Well, he's a real bloke, you know. I remember laying there, I got off tour and my wife said, hey, you got to watch this young fella on Idol. I said, right, so I'm laying back there with the remote and next thing he's come on and started to sing. And I said, well, get the phones, we'll start voting for him, you know. He's someone that I found was real and you know, you meet a lot of people in this industry, and good and bad and ugly and that, but it's nice to meet people who are real. Nice to get a text when your daughter's born. Yeah, stuff that means something to a father. And we were impressed with just his humility, you know, and not many people have that, so it's very important.
And Richard, I mean, he's come such a long way in such a short time. Mm-hmm. Is there anything you put that down to?
I think it's just, you know, from the first time I ever met Shannon, just that he's a genuine article, you know. And we are starting to live in a world of, you know, modern pop music. It gets very superficial and homogenised and everything. Somebody's got to fly the flag, Shannon. It ought to be you.
You take up the baton, son.
You've done the hard yard, son. Yeah. Congratulations.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah. And that hard work and gritty determination, Shannon, certainly pay off. You win 5 ARIA number one chart awards, 3 MTV awards, and become the only Australian artist to have 11 top 10 hits all in a row. There's no doubt that your songs have become synonymous with true blue Australian values, which is why comedian Matthew Hardy prepared this next roast.
Hey!
Good day, mate.
Good evening. It's an absolute honour to be here. Now, the main quality, if you ask me, about Shannon is how Australian he is. He's a rural bloke. And that means he's not completely as in touch with technology as he'd like to be. I mean, he thinks MySpace is something Rochelle won't give him enough of. He thinks broadband's the elastic on Kim Beazley's underpants. Shannon is so Australian, he's been deliberately blocking his dunny in the hope that he might one day meet Kenny. Yeah. Seriously, Shannon is so Australian, he doesn't care how many times John Farnham says this tour is going to be the last time, he'll buy a ticket for the next time too. Shannon is so Australian, he cares about conservation. To the point where when his wife's water broke, he said, save that, the garden can do with it. Shannon Noll is so Australian, he ate the dingo's baby, ladies and gentlemen. He's so Australian, keep this quiet, Centrelink don't even know he does gigs. My favourite Shannon Noll lyrics have to be the first lines from his superb song, Drive. Now, surely the spirit of John Lennon's songwriting genius was surging through the day they wrote, I've got a car, I've got a big black shiny car. You can worship Warnie, you can love Paul Hogan. But here's to Shannon Noll, our best love Bogan.
Matthew Hardy, ladies and gentlemen. Matthew Hardy. Thanks, Matthew.
And after the break, we meet Shannon's biggest fans, but first, messages from two international performers.
Hey, Shannon. What's happening, mate? This is your life. It's your old buddy Richie Sambora talking to you from sunny California. Hey, man. We had a great time. I met you when we first started to write together and took you for a boat ride and we started to talk about life. And lo and behold, we wrote a few great songs. You got a classic voice, man, with a contemporary flair. And you're my good buddy. And I hope you're having a great time on this. This is your life.
Hey, Shannon, it's Richard Marks, and I just wanted to say congratulations on everything that's been happening to you. You really have come a long way from Australian Idol. And I was thinking that maybe this would also be a good time for me to publicly tell you once and for all that I'm just not attracted to you in that way. Have a great time tonight, buddy.
Thank you.
It's Kyle. I'm so sorry I couldn't be there, but I did want to come on and just let people know what a champion you are, and why you're so successful is because it doesn't matter what's going on in your personal life, you'll always do the right thing by your fans. Seriously, from the bottom of my heart, I wish you the best. I know you're doing great things, and I can't see the end. So keep going, mate. Good luck with everything. I love you.
Congratulations, Shannon, on your tribute tonight. Having been on Idol myself, I know what a roller coaster ride it can be. But I hear through the grapevine, and especially my mum, she's one of your biggest fans, that you're an inspiration for a lot of Aussies, so congratulations again. But I hear you're coming over to the American markets, and I don't know if that's big enough for the two of us, mate. Just kidding. Anyway, when you get here, we'll have a couple of beers. Cheers.
Welcome back to This Is Your Life from Shannon Noll. Shannon, in 2007, you turned your attention to the stage, appearing in War of the Worlds alongside Rachel Beck. You hire an agent and set your sights on acting. And we understand you are still trying to perfect the tears on cue. Is that right? Is that right?
Yeah, I did it earlier. Not too bad. Play that video again and watch me go.
You also make a cameo role in a commercial for the Sydney Swans. And two of the Swannies are here tonight to pay tribute to you. Would you please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Nick Davis and Adam Goods. You know Rochelle? Hey, Nick. Nick, he's been a big supporter of the Swannies for a long while, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. He's an ambassador of the club. He's always put his hand up to play in our charity game. He's always rung me up for a free pair of boots before the game.
A free pair of boots
every year. But no, he's a good supporter. He's a good mate of mine. We've had a few heart-to-hearts about some of the things that he thinks I should put in my game that he used to do.
One of them worked too. He's a tackling machine now. I reckon I'll take credit for that one.
But yeah, and for the free pair of boots, I thought, mate, I'd bring you a Swannies jumper.
Oh, going off.
So you can stop hassling me and leave me alone.
And of course, Adam, he fancied himself as a real player. He thought about playing at one stage, didn't he?
Yeah, it got mentioned a little bit earlier. He moved to Sydney to play football, not this Australian Idol stuff. So it was the Australian Idol stuff that got in the way of him pursuing his AFL football career.
Right.
And the odd motorbike accident as well, Mike. So I've had a fair bit to do with Shannon over the years at the games. I remember 2005 doing a lap of honour at the grand final after we won, and here's this guy practically jumping over the fence, trying to hug me and kiss me, saying congratulations on the win.
That's right, it was. Right, I run down there, yeah.
Thanks very much, guys. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Will.
Now, Shannon, you and Michelle can have all the friends in the world, but I guess without children, it's just not the same. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome their three beautiful children, Cody, Blake and Sienna. Now, listen, what's the best thing about spending time with Dad?
Playing football, passing the football to him, and going rabbit hunting.
Rabbit hunting.
And Blake, do you have a favourite song that Dad sings?
What about me?
What about you? Can you sing that for us?
What about me?
Oh, fantastic. There's serious competition in the family already.
Jeez. I might have to play backup singer soon.
Well, thanks, guys. Thanks for coming in. After the break, we'll learn how Shannon's music has completely changed some lives. Welcome back to This Is Your Life. Shannon, your music over just a few short years has reached so many Australians of all ages. And it's that singing from the heart which is why so many relate to you. Now, not too long ago, you are blown away by this beautiful letter from a desperate young husband and father of three. It reads, Shannon, I hit rock bottom. I was in my car and all that was on my mind was putting my car through a brick wall at 110 kilometres an hour. All I know is there were tears running down my face. I couldn't do it anymore. I wanted to end it. Your song came on the radio and it was lift. No one will understand the effect that song had on me at that exact moment. It saved me. I hope one day I get to shake your hand and say thank you with all my heart. And we thought we would give him the opportunity to do just that. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Tuan Tram.
Hey, Tuan.
Sit down, mate. Take a seat.
Tuan, just, if you can, put us back in that car. You're looking at a brick wall. Your marriage is breaking up. So what's going through your mind?
It was just a real emotional time. Everything had just finally come to a head. My marriage, you know, my three kids involved as well, and you throw everything else in it. And I just made the decision. I really couldn't do it anymore. It hurt too much. And the decision was made. I was going to do it. And as eerie as it sounds, Shannon's song came on the radio, and you hear the song a million times on the radio, but you never really listen. And that night, just listening to Shannon's lyrics in his song, it just pulled me out of what would have been, you know, I wouldn't be sitting here if it wasn't for Shannon. That's how deep I'd gotten. So yeah, it's incredible. It's a credit to just his ability to be able to reach people in the strange situation, in the situation you wouldn't have expected.
This was very hard for Tuan to do tonight, Shannon. It was a very, very difficult thing, as you can imagine, for him to do. So let me ask you, why do it?
This is nice for Shannon. He speaks for us, for the guys that, you know, don't have a voice to be able to speak. He speaks, you know, to us and for us as well. And that's, I think, is very, probably a very special thing.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Shannon, on those sentiments, we would ask if you wouldn't mind closing the show tonight with the song that means so much to Tuan and to so many other people. So
no problem at all, mate. It'd be my pleasure.
All right.
Thanks, Shannon.
After you. Ladies and gentlemen, Shannon Noll with Lift.
guest stay at the Diamond Hotel in Sydney.